coming up on a brand new episode of Sports Zone.
Soccer is back as the Blue Hawks begin their 2018 campaign.
Women's volleyball looks to continue their flaming hot Cheeto start.
Learn about an off-season journey of a cross-country captain.
The debates are fun, aren't they? Tell us who's better, Brady or Rogers. All that and much more coming up right now. Welcome in, and it's a brand new semester of Sports Zone. I'm Pat Hunt, and we've got a new face in the studio.
And I'm CJ Ponton, and we got a lot to get to, Pat, so let's roll it. Let's start off a little bit of women's soccer, shall we? Olay! Number 22, Loras College, taking on the Big Blue out of Millikan University. Duhawks looking to pick up their third win on the season. So we fast forward to the first half here. Elizabeth Mills going to take it. Shot denied, but spring came early this year. Cleaning it up, Kiki Cabrera, able to make it 1-0 advantage. All right, so strange occurrence here later in the game. We're going to fast forward, and this is honestly like playing FIFA 18 with your buddies. No defense whatsoever by Big Blue. Riley O'Brien with the goal. Congrats on her first collegiate goal. All right, so now, Duhawks, penalty kick late in the game, trying to put the icing on the cake. Bryn Jacoby says, who needs a bakery? I can do it myself. Her late goal sealed the game for the Duhawks, now 3-0 all-time against Millikan. With her efforts this past week, junior Jenny Wick was named the American Rivers Conference Defensive Player of the Week, aiding the Duhawks to a 3-2 start. Wick limited opponents this week to just 7 total shots. And in the Duhawks match versus St. Mary's, Wick's first goal of the year doubled as the match winner. So congrats and keep up the hard work on the pitch. Now to the men's side of the pitch we go. Duhawks looking to keep the momentum rolling after ousting Elmhurst in the first match of the season 1-0. So pick it up early in the first half. Corner kick for St. Olaf, but knocked out of the box by the Duhawks defense. Another look into the tightly crammed space, protecting the goalie. Okay, we go to the second half now. Duhawks up 1-0, and whoa! Look out! Theranos Gaye draws the yellow card for St. Olaf after a pretty blatant cheap shot. His mom did not like that one, neither did his coach. Overall, the only score of the game came from a Marcus Singleton goal in the 66th minute. Loras starts 2-0 for the fourth time in 5 seasons and has Carthage on the road this upcoming Saturday.
Let's move from the pitch to the court as women's volleyball took an undefeated record into the AWC over the weekend as they hosted the Loras Invitational. Friday night was a barn burner for the Duhawk faithful as Loras took on 14th ranked Northwestern. Michelle Budden gets the Duhawks going in the first set with this kill to make things 16-15. Northwestern continued to battle though as they get one down and even it up. All tournament selection Paige Griffith gets in on the action with a kill of her own to sway the momentum back in the Duhawks' favor. Riding on that momentum, Duhawk Nation gets back into it after a service ace from Kayla Kinney puts the Duhawks in prime position for a game win, and Budden slams it home to give the Duhawks a 1-0 lead. Tied up in the second set, Kelly Bogey's able to get a kill of her own, and what do you know? Budden again with another kill to give Loras a 6-point lead. Sarah Lewis gives game 2 to the Duhawks with this monster kill, but the Eagles would continue to fight. An Eagles ace would give them and star player Mariah Halverson, who slams home a kill right there, the energy to take game 3, but it was all Duhawks from there as Jenna LaCorte puts down a huge kill early in the third set to put the Duhawks up, and to finish it off, Bogey nails home the game winner to send the massive Duhawk crowd home happy with a 3-1 victory. No walk in the park Saturday as the team took the court against 9th-ranked Gustavus Adolphus. Here, Bussey starts things off with an ace, followed by star duo Kayla Kinney and Kelly Bogey tipping in a series of kills to finish off set 1 and give the Duhawks the early advantage as they continue to ride the momentum. Kinney continued the stellar play with an ace to begin the second set, but the Gusties then showed why they're a top 10 program. A block right here at the net gets things rolling for the Gusties, and they followed up with another kill on the baseline to put them in control for the remainder of the contest. The Duhawks kept it close, but errors riddled the last few sets for the purple and gold. A service error from Kinney, followed by a hit to the net from Griffiths, and a gusty kill. Finish off the Duhawks. Loras can't quite pull it out in the end, as Gustavus Adolphus gives volleyball their first loss on the year. Looking to build upon their 8-1 record, the women's volleyball team is getting ready to take on Cornell College at 7:30 over in the AWC.
We've got reporter Ben Friedman live at Willis Court with a preview of tonight's action. Ben.
The Duhawks will take on the Cornell Rams here tonight on Loris's home floor. Rams come into tonight's matchup with a 2-4 record, but don't count this team out. This is a team that went 25-8 last season, 9-0 in their home conference. Take a look out for senior Nicole Ciara to bring the energy. She was the Midwest Conference Volleyball Offensive Performer of the Week, averaging over four and a half sets in the Rams' last four games. Duhawks coming into the match tonight with only one loss on the season. They are 8-1 at the moment. And out of those eight wins, only two of them have gone into five sets. That means that this team is doing a fantastic job of getting out and ahead on their opponents. Great job by the Duhawks. Watch out for junior Michelle Budden. She's leading the team with 82 kills this season, 11 of those coming in their last matchup against North Central. And don't forget about junior Kayla Kinney, all the way from Las Vegas. She's doing a fantastic job for the Duhawks, putting up 3.5 points per set, and she'll look to keep bringing the energy tonight for the squad. Game time's at 7:30, so wrap up what you're eating and get on down here to Lillis Court. I'm Ben Friedman. CJ and Pat, back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Ben. We will definitely be sure to head on over there after the show. And CJ, what a start for the women's volleyball team.
Well, I had the pleasure to call both of their games against both Gustavus as well as the University of Northwestern St. Paul this past weekend, and they look dynamite. They have a lot of weapons, and they're 8-1 right now, and I'm really surprised that they're not ranked nationally.
But yeah, be sure to look at the polls in the next coming week here. I mean, the atmosphere on Friday was absolutely unbelievable. It's really special to be there in the AWC.
It's just crazy. Winning teams are built by winning attitudes, and reporter Michael Rundy is here to show us one leader on campus who has just that.
The Loris men's cross-country team season has already gotten underway and are off to a solid start after taking third in the final overall standings of the All-American Invite, which was hosted by Luther this past weekend. The Duhawks seem to have set high expectations for themselves this season, and one team captain is no stranger to setting high expectations.
Hi, my name is Nate Goslin. I'm a senior and captain of the Loris cross country team.
Nate was voted one of three team captains for this season, and this past summer, he showed just why he deserved this honor.
So it started my junior year summer. I ran with 20 teammates, and then I wanted to make sure that the freshmen were comfortable and make sure that the guys were having good summers and that they knew I was working just as hard as they were.
Goslin managed to run with each of his teammates during their summer training. That's more than 30 runners, and accomplishing such a feat did not go unnoticed.
Well, it was 100% his idea, so I love it. I think it's great. You know, a lot of people see running as an individual sport, and I think when you have someone on your team that does that, that just puts an emphasis on how much of a team sport it is.
And this focus on the team has made an impact that is sure to carry into the rest of the season.
He's a senior. He's not going to be here next year. But he's still, like, every, like, 2 weeks he checked up on me, like, see how I was doing, how, like, running was, and, like, just how school was coming.
He may only have one final year, but the man they call Goose won't leave without an impact.
I think it shows that I care about their success. I want them to be running in the summer. I hope that they care about my success, that they wanted to run with me. I remember when I came in as a freshman, I was like, oh, wow, these are all these really big, scary, fast people running around. And I think it just makes people more comfortable and less scared in the first couple weeks.
Reporting for SportsZone, I'm Michael Rundy.
Duhawk football looked to tally their first W in the win column on Saturday evening as they traveled to Chicagoland's Lisle, Illinois to take on the Benedictine University Eagles. Cody Mile got the run game going early for the Duhawks as he scampers here for a couple of first downs. He eventually totaled 137 yards on the ground while averaging nearly 4.5 yards per run on the day. Noah Sigworth looks for wideout Sam Maloney right here in the back of the end zone, but he's pushed out by the defender. Can't come down with it, and the Duhawks have to settle for a field goal. On the ensuing drive, Benedictine powers home the first touchdown of the game to take a 7-3 lead. But not even 2 minutes later, speedy freshman Elijah Thomas turns the corner, and he finds pay dirt for the Duhawks to regain the lead. And then with just 2 minutes left in the half, Cody Mile is able to find some daylight up the middle from 35 yards out, and with a nice block here at the end by wideout Brad Belko, he gets into the end zone to extend the Duhawks' lead. Elijah Thomas was back at it again, and he went all Devin Hester on us to begin the second half as he goes virtually untouched, going 100 yards for the kickoff return touchdown to give the Duhawks a 25-13 lead over the Eagles. after a defensive stand and blocking one of three kicks on the day. As you see right here, getting their hands up. Noah Sigrith drops back once again and is able to friend Brad Belko for an 85-yard touchdown. That's actually the longest touchdown of either player's Duhawk career. That one extends the Duhawk lead to a comfortable 32-13 margin, but as a Bears fan, don't tell the Bears that's a comfortable lead. Nonetheless, the first career interception for Ryan Wohler seals the game for the Duhawks as they came back to Dubuque with a 39-20 win. After recording 169 all-purpose yards on Saturday, freshman Elijah Thomas was named the American Rivers Conference Special Teams Player of the Week. Highlighted by his incredible 100-yard kickoff return, Thomas also had a 16-yard touchdown against the Eagles. The Duhawks will have a bye this week before gearing up for American Rivers Conference play September 22nd at Luther. How big was that win for the Duhawks after what was probably a disappointing loss?
That was huge to rally back, especially the way Eau Claire came out and just kind of pounded the Duhawks.
Oh, yeah. But
Elijah Thomas, what can you say? That man, he reminds me of Tyreek Hill on the Kansas City Chiefs.
Tariq Cohen on the Bears.
It just, speed kills, my man.
Yeah, he's able to be used. Coach Almanac uses him in such a strategic way. It's really cool to watch, and it's going to be exciting watching this young team progress throughout the rest of the year.
I'm excited. Their next game against Luther.
Oh, it's going to be huge. Yeah.
The women's golf team took a trip to Monmouth on Sunday to compete in the Fighting Scott Invitational. Anna Marie Zahn finished sixth in the overall standings. Zahn knocked off two strokes from her Saturday score, shooting 8 over par while finishing 3 strokes behind the winner. The Duhawks will hit the links once again on Saturday in Galena for the Clark invite. Moving on from the greens to the courts, women's tennis hosted Luther yesterday at the Tucker Tennis Courts. The Duhawks were hoping to increase their record yesterday heading into the match at a 2-2 draw. Things got off to a great start with double duos Audrey Hines and Noli Hallman taking their doubles match 8-4 at one doubles. However, things took a turn for the worst as the Duhawks went on to lose their other two doubles matches. Moving into the singles, we saw some impressive play from returners like sophomore Maddie Smith and junior McKenna Kraft. While these matches were filled with some hard-fought points, the home court advantage wasn't enough as the Norse would go on to win all 6 singles matches. The Duhawks hit the courts again tomorrow against Cornell in Mount Vernon. Although the Duhawks fell short against Luther yesterday, senior Emma Cook accomplished something incredible on Saturday. While playing Cook managed to take down her opponent 6-1 and 7-5 in an absolutely nail biter, securing her 50th total win of her collegiate career. This not only extended her win streak to 21 matches, but also raised her record to 30-3 at the third spot of the singles lineup.
And now, it's the part we all know is the reason you're watching. It's free food time. And all you have to do is answer this question and you'll get some free Buffalo Wild Wings. Good deal?
All right, so here's the question. Pretty simple. How many career wins does tennis player Emma Cook have? Is it A, 35, B, 50, or C, 55?
Hop onto Twitter at @LCTV_sports, tweet us your answer, and if you're one of the first ones right, wings are all yours. Stay with us and we'll announce the winner at the end of the show.
Don't move a single muscle. We have Duhawks QB Noah Sigrith in studio to talk about the team's big win.
And we discuss if Aaron Rodgers' miraculous comeback against the Bears means he's really above Tom Brady on the greatest of all time list. We'll be back right after this.
What do you guys want to do?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
1, 2, ready, go. Gonna pull the stops, gonna make it go. You're living on a wing and a prayer. Gonna put them legs together. You know it's now or never.
Joining us in the studio tonight is Duhawks quarterback Noah Sigrith. Thank you so much for coming on.
Yeah, of course.
All right, so I'm sure after what was probably a disappointing loss in week 1, how big was that win going into Benedictine and knocking them off?
It was huge, you know, us being a young team and all, you know, it's real big to be able to bounce back from a loss like that. You know, it shows some promising signs that we're on the right track.
Mm-hmm.
So Noah, going into this week with a bye and having Luther that following weekend, how are you and the team looking to kind of recover from a pretty heavy, you know, workload within the first 2 weeks?
Yeah, so I mean, we got bumps and bruises here and there. So I mean, it's good to be able to, you know, work those things out. And, you know, we also get a whole week to, you know, progress as a young team. We're able to, you know, get balls thrown, you know, work on our checks and, you know, kind of do our thing and be able to grow as a young team in that week. So it's real big for us.
I'm sure. Well, thank you so much for coming in. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have. Right. We're going to move on, but thanks so much. Good luck with the rest of the year.
Of course. Yeah,
thanks again, man.
Yeah.
The Duhawk women's tennis team is off to a solid start this year and is looking to make some noise this year in the American Rivers Conference. I hit the court this week with women's tennis player Fran Roach.
What's up, guys? We are back for a new semester on SportsZone, which means a new semester of Coast to Coast. I'm Pat Hunt, and I'm here with women's tennis player Fran Roach. Ready to do this?
Of course. Let's do it.
All right, so first question. All of us had a visit to Loris, and obviously we all liked it since we're here. What was your favorite thing that either happened or the best thing that you saw on your visit to Loris?
I'd probably say just having anyone and everyone stop and talk to you and make sure that you're enjoying the experience, and if you had any questions, they were always willing to answer them.
Very, very, very good people here at Loris. Obviously, Duhawks, always support Duhawks. Second question, there's so many good places to eat in Dubuque. What is your favorite as we hop over the net?
I'd probably say Salsa's downtown. Big fan of the Mexican food here.
As am I. Huge Mexican food guy. You won't find a bigger one. All right, last question. What are your personal goals for the team as well as personal goals for yourself and goals for the team as a whole?
As a team as a whole, I'd say just working, and personally, working hard, improving from last year, and staying positive with everything and everyone. We're enjoying the new courts here, and so that always is exciting.
Oh yeah, brand new courts, brand new renovations to the Rock Bowl. That's Fran Roach. Hopefully you learned a little bit more about her. That was Coast to Coast.
It's time for something new here on SportsZone, SZ Extra. Every show we're going to look at something way out there in the sports world, post a poll on Twitter for you guys to decide, and give you our thoughts on it.
So this week, Aaron Rodgers obviously put on a pretty ridiculous performance, pretty much on one leg, leading the Packers back to a victory against my beloved Chicago Bears. We put out a Twitter poll asking you guys which number 12 is really the GOAT, and look at these results. Aaron Rodgers just running away with it. I mean, I don't know, I guess I can expect it as a Bears fan here. Right here at that kind of tri-state area with us, Wisconsin, and Iowa. So many Packers fans are here.
That's true, but he's also one bad man.
He is such a bad man, but I really, really wish that he would tone it down against my Chicago Bears. All right, but let's see what someone on Twitter had to say here. I know a lot of people have some strong opinions. Jake Ruggles, it's Tom Brady because he is unreal and because I am a Bears fan. Amen to that. Better analysis than I probably could have ever done.
Ruggles. Where have we heard that name before?
Ruggles. Oh, I don't know. Man, watch basketball this season. Watch basketball season. You'll probably get a hint. With that, we got to take a quick break, but I'm telling you, you do not want to go anywhere. CJ lays out his top five plays of the week, and CJ stars.
Pat and I feel the pressure of being a Loris Duhawks kicker.
And I know you want that free B-dubs. We'll announce the winner after this short break.
Okay, Josh, do your stuff.
Okay, people, you know the drill. Can't do it only, guys. Sometimes you gotta live what you believe. Open your arms, cause that's where it's from. God be with you and with me. But no world is love, is love. Generosity, pass it on. A little from up above. To me. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
All right, it's time for CJ's top five plays, aka time to bring out the popcorn. All right, at number five, here we go. Unveiling a new segment. Eau Claire looking to run the pitch play and whoop! Ball on the ground, scooped up by Danny Cam, and he could go all the way. 76 yard scoop and score by the freshman. Hey, you'll begin to notice a recurring pattern there. All right, number four, Elizabeth Mills denied on the long shot attempt, but boom, Kiki Cabrera using the old noggins to put the DoHawks ahead in the match. See what I did there? Yeah, exactly. All right, number three, to the hardwood with Paige Griffith here. Just wait for it. Kelly Bogey with the kill and the dagger. Big thing here. Loris knocking off number 14, Northwestern. It was a lot of fun to call that game. Number two, back to the pitch. Freshman Riley O'Brien, right into the goal. Congrats again, Riley, on that first goal. And number one, Mr. Electric himself, Elijah Thomas. Yeah, you know, I'm just gonna catch the ball in the end zone, kind of casually take it out, and whoop! Finds a hole and takes it 100 yards to the house. Someone get this kid on my fantasy team. Oh my goodness. But yeah, three out of the top five plays featured freshman athletes. And to that, I say, job well done, guys.
Whoa. CJ and I are usually up in the booth, but even we know that being a collegiate kicker can be a stressful job.
Yeah, add in that SportsZone cameras, and that's in heart beating out of your chest scenario. Whew, I was sweating just warming up out there.
What's up, guys? We are back for our first sports challenge of the semester.
You guys are used to Pat and I calling the games up in the booth, but we wanted to get in the minds of college kickers themselves. So, Pat, we're going to kick some field goals on this fine morning here in the Rock Bowl.
You ready to do this?
Let's hope. One for one, baby.
So we can see why the NFL moved the extra point back, because, you know, pretty easy for a bunch of sports zone anchors. Yeah, it was my suggestion just to move back 5 yards, and that was the one that just messed up.
Hey, should we try the hash? I mean, this is a sports challenge. Say you achieve your goal today, Pat. All right, so we got one more challenge. And Coach Helminiak, if I make this 40 yards out, I'll be looking for a kicker next year.
And I'll be alone in the booth.
Missed it by that much. Well, looks like I came out to the field, had one goal in mind, Pat. Give me that. That's all mine. That's my trophy.
Yep, you deserve it. You have the golden boot, and I should have brought my cleats.
Yep, pays dividends, people. But until next time, we'll see you later.
It's that time again, so turn up your TV, computer, phone, or whatever else you're watching us on, because it's time to give away some free Buffalo Wild Wings.
And the start of the show, we asked you the question, how many career wins does tennis player Emma Cook have? Was it A, 35, B, 50, or C, 55?
And the answer is B50, which makes Brendan Nugent our winner. Be sure to keep an eye on your mailbox.
Nugent! And with that, we're out of time.
Make sure you tune back in again next week, same time, same place, for LCTV News.
And catch Pat and I again in 2 weeks right here on SportsZone.
As always, it was a pleasure bringing you the latest and greatest in DoHawk athletics.
So until next time, peace.